How can you become the next Steve Jobs? When we speak of the few legendary businessmen who already walk along with us on the globe, Steve Jobs is a name that can't be eradicated from the list ever. Starting the first trillion-dollar company in the world, Apple, Steve Jobs was much more than a businessman, a CEO, and a mere investor. Above all, the man had a visionary motive and let his natural instincts decide for himself. Not to forget how he made 100% use of his brilliant mind to help him stay at the top of the summit. Since then, a lot of young visionaries have been following Steve Jobs' life closely, wanting to become one themselves. You would be surprised to know that this is not an impossible task to be accomplished. Rather, you can inherit Steve Jobs' thought process and hard work just by adopting some of his behaviors. So, without any further ado, let's take a look into a few important aspects that would help you use your potentials to the fullest, making you another Steve Jobs on the way. Having room for innovations. To be honest, Steve Jobs could really emerge out of all his counterparts due to his unique innovations. He could sense what the world wanted exactly at that point in time and infested all of his ideas in the same. For example, he was the first one to realize the commercial potentials that a mere mouse of a computer holds. This particular phenomenon was the real breakthrough for Apple and gained popularity globally. Hence, the first and foremost step before spending millions of bucks and years, you need to realize the needs of the people by staying connected to innovative websites and journals. In this way, you would easily detect the emerging technologies and ideas that the world is yet to see. Comebacks aren't always bad. Well, who hasn't heard of the infamous tale of Apple once kicking out Steve Jobs during his initial days as an employee? Right when Jobs was a little less qualified to work in such a big firm, Apple was a bit picky regarding the hiring procedure. Moreover, things did not go the best for the company then. Hence, they had to deploy a lot of people, but instead of getting offended or holding grudges against the company, Steve Jobs worked really hard on himself to be selected the next time. As a result, he returned back to the company only as the CEO this time. Hence, it is a clear depiction of if you ever put aside an idea for whatever reasons, always have room for reconsidering it some other day. Who knows, your discarded idea could turn into the biggest business venture for you in the future. The signs say a lot. Those days are gone long back when creators ignored what was on the outside and just focused on what was on the inside. But the only thing that makes Steve Jobs different from the other CEO is that he equally focused on the hardware and the aesthetics of the product like he did on the software. People reviewed Apple products as the best packaged ones and immediately had an emotional attachment to them, starting from the beautifully packaged boxes to the perfectly furnished phone designs to an even much better interface. The users experienced the actual joy of running a smartphone. Hence, the idea of making the customer fall in love with a product, which eventually made them overlook any technical faults, even really benefited Jobs. Know what you're best at. Knowing your strengths and weaknesses could be your biggest attributes towards deciding your success story. Similarly, Steve Jobs knew the lanes he was the best at. For example, even from an early age, he found out that technology and designs were his niches. This is the reason why, wherever he worked, Jobs stuck to his skills and did the job. Unlike him, there were a lot of budding entrepreneurs who focused on achieving it all here and there. Unfortunately, a lot of their ventures fell flat on their faces, causing them a huge loss. On the other hand, even when Steve Jobs worked at Pixar Studios, he focused on design and computer technology fields, instead of interfering with the topics he had less knowledge of. Hence, your strengths decide where your life will go. At the same time, your weaknesses define where you shouldn't go. Both of them are the two sides of the same coin. Connecting with your market and being professional. Not only did Steve Jobs was successful in creating aesthetically pleasing products, but he was also the best at selling that off as well. We mean, have you ever seen one of his Apple conferences? The man knows exactly what he's doing and what he wants to convey to the audience. Steve Jobs even recognized the target market, which made him personally connect to the audience. He let the customer know what they were spending their money on, which empathized with the latter. On the other hand, he was the most professional he could be. In an interview, Jobs revealed that, although the office had a light environment to work in, none of the employees knew more than each other's names. Steve Jobs was a friendly boss as well, but kept his personal and professional lives pretty far off. This is the reason why he hardly got himself in any unnecessary controversy tarnishing his own name. Dreaming to achieve the biggest heights of success isn't bad, as long as you fall in love with your professional life. Your work environment should be lighthearted and peace-friendly without feeling like a burden. Hence, idolizing overachievers like Steve Jobs could be intimidating sometimes, but trust us, if you can go after it step by step, then things may eventually seem easier.